Hey guys, once again, it's Keith Brown in Tack Room Devotional. I'm so glad you're here. Glory to God. Amen. Last week we talked about putting on Christ. We found out that that doesn't mean just put on Jesus, but it talks about an authority and a power that we have to be able to represent Him and to live our lives out according to His life. What I mean by that is Jesus Christ means Jesus the Anointed One. He was anointed with power from God through the unction of the Holy Spirit. We talked about that last week. But then he tells us in Matthew chapter 28, he says, "All power and authority has been given unto me in heaven and in earth. Now you go and in my name be witnesses to me and teach and all those things." And then it says in Mark chapter 16, and the things that, Mark chapter 16 says, "And those that believe, these signs shall follow. They'll lay hands on the sick and cast out devils," and so forth. It's talking about receiving from Jesus this power and authority in order to be witnesses for Him. That's what the anointing speaks of. So many times in the Bible, when we read Christ, remember, Jesus is the Christ, but sometimes it's talking about the anointing or the authority and the power that He's passed on to the church to represent Him. Amen. Well, I want to take it a step further, a little bit further. If we go to, let me back up one more thing. Remember, 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 24 says, "Christ is the power and the wisdom of God." Christ is the power and the wisdom of God. So we need to know that. We need to know the wisdom of God, and we need to understand that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think according to the power that works in us. We need to let that power work. Well, if we take it a step further, we go to 1 John chapter 4, verse 8. It says this, "He who does not love God does not know God, for God is love." Amen. If you go to verse 16, it also says, "And we have known and believed the love that God has for us, for God is love, and he who abides in love abides in God, and God in him." Now, God's love is way different than the love of the world. The love of the world says, "I'll love you as long as you love me the way I want to be loved, how I want to be loved." And when you don't satisfy that need, you're out of here. I'll get somebody else. God's love is different. It's called agape love. First of all, it's unconditional. No matter what you do, God loves you anyway. Isn't that amazing? And God tells us we need to love like Him. Right here, we just read it. So we love unconditional, no matter what they do. Kind of like a mom with her kids or a dad with their kids. Many times the kids do wrong, but we don't get rid of them. We don't divorce them. I don't know why that works that way. We divorce our wives and our husbands, but we don't divorce our kids. Oh no, whatever they do, we stay in there. Well, a relationship with husband and wife should be stronger even than with the kids, believe it or not. But anyway, I'm gonna move on. We need to love like God. That's first of all, unconditional. But second of all, it's sacrificial. In other words, we did wrong. We're the ones that sinned. And the wages of sin is death. And all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We are the ones that drove the wedge between us and God, where we didn't have access to Him, right? But along comes Jesus and satisfies the judgment that's against sin by the shedding of blood. The Bible says, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. So He shed His perfect blood for you and I, that we now have access to the Father once again. That's how we are born again. Amen. So Jesus is the perfect example of the love of God. Not only does He love us unconditional, but He also loves us sacrificial. He comes and fixes the wrong that we did towards Him. And if we're to love like Him, we're to love the same way. Unconditionally, first of all, but second of all, sacrificially. We should be willing to say, "Wait a minute, you did me wrong, but hey, I forgive you, and I'll fix what you did wrong towards me so that we can have a relationship." That's the love of God. We need to love like that. And I want to take this, when we're talking about putting on Christ, I want to take this tomorrow to a new level for you and I. First of all, understand the love of God. It's the most powerful the greatest source of power here on this earth. I'll show you the perfect power of God. Here it is. Jesus hanging on a cross. To the world, it looked like he was weak, but to God, it was power. We're going to pick that up tomorrow. Talk about the power of love. That's why we need to love like God and know that God is love. Hey, remember, Jesus loves you. We love you. We pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek him and serve him. And again, we'll see you tomorrow.